This is Brad Davidson. He's a friend of mine. We've been friends for, dear Lord, I think like 12 years now.
Yeah, a long time.
And he's a world-class trainer. Brad trains some of the top athletes, professional athletes in the world, actually. He trained me for my black belt. He's trained me for many years, because of my injuries. So he's very savvy to sports injuries, to scoliosis, and he's the only trainer that never hurt me. So I thought during this time, I asked Brad if he would be willing to come on and talk about exercise routines you could do safely at home with no equipment. And there's a lot of people, including me, putting stuff out there on the internet that, you know, we want you moving and we all have good intentions. But we thought it'd be a good idea to actually have someone who knows what they're doing and that could organize it for you in a really safe and effective way. And Brad also wrote a book. It's Stark Naked, right? The 21-Day Metabolic Reset?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
So Brad is really good at this. And I mean, he's just got a ton of knowledge. It's less about, for him, I think, about how you look. I mean, why don't you tell them what this is about for you?
Yeah. So my world is all about performance. And it's less about how you look. It's about how you perform. Most of the fitness world is all about looking good, feeling horrible. And my big point that I like to make with the people I work with is this. When you get home at night, are you taking such great care of yourself? Are you in such great health, such great fitness levels that the people you love the most, are they getting the best of you or the rest of you? And the only way they get the best of you is to learn how to take better care of yourself overall in general. And a lot of the ideas of just going to beating the crud out of yourself at the gym, like, that doesn't work. Like, you're training like crazy, you get home, you feel horrible, they're paying the price. So my world is all about the best version of you showing up every single day, and especially at the end of the day, or right now, all day long, with the people you love the most.
I love that. And so you came up with a workout. We're not going to do the workout for you because it's too hard for us to do it in these little tiny screens. We're going to actually have, Brad is going to give you his link to his website where you can go and you can actually sign up for the entire workout, right?
Yeah.
So tell them about that. What do they get?
Yeah, so what I've done is, I want people to understand, like, the idea is not just to go work out to work out. The idea is to go work out with a plan, with a specific result in mind. And I think right now with everything we're dealing with, the result in mind should be these three things. One, exercise to strengthen the immune system. Two, exercise to optimize your energy. And three, exercise to reduce your overall stress load. The first thing it does every day is it starts you out with something called CARS, controlled articular rotations. It's one of the best tools I've come up with and discovered over the years that helps improve joint mobility, reduce joint pain, things like that. We're sitting around a lot more than we typically do on a daily basis. So I want to make sure the joints don't get stiffened up. So you can do that every day. And then it has the workout of the day. And my system is based on a high, medium, and low system. What I've learned over the years is you can't train hard every single day and expect a good outcome. That is the best way to wipe you out. And in this point in time, that is the best way to hamper your immune system. Mm-hmm. So often the people I work with that are high-level triathletes and marathon runners, they're the ones that have the weak immune systems. One of these are always doing is trying to prevent them from getting sick.
When I trained with you very specifically for 6 months, I trained a very specific way. And when I went in for that black belt test, which was the hardest test for me of all, 3 hours solid of just getting my rear end kicked. And I was in my late 40s and I didn't get hurt. And I mean, I was tired at the end. Don't get me wrong. I was whipped, but I did not feel like I was going to die. And so, and where it normally would take me a month to recover from something like that, it took me a couple days. And so I know a lot of it had to do with that training smarter, not harder. And so now while people are home, we want to make sure they're moving.
Yes.
But the last thing we want to do is get them injured because, you know, then they're down for good and they can't really go see people as easily and whatever. So we want to make sure that they're getting this good workout. So if they go to your website is braddavidson.com, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Brad.
As soon as it opens up, you'll see exactly where to go to access this whole free workout bundle. It's really easy to find.
And so there's workouts of the day. Is there,
And
they'll just see everything, all the tools they need are right there.
Yeah, yeah. So again, it tells you how to download the app, so the workouts are there every day. And again, there's an app. Yeah, and every day, and you can track everything you do every single day. It's a really easy to use, very functional app. And there's also a little course that goes with it, teaching specific to how we're exercising for this period of time, how I built the program. For example, I have 2 hard days a week on there. And the 2 hard days are actually the days that are used to boost the immune system. They've actually found there's ways you can train aggressively as long as it's 30 minutes or less, they'll actually boost NK cells, natural killer cells. It'll go scavenge around, find cancer cells and infected cells and kill them. Well, we want that benefit. So there's two of those days built in. And then there's 2 days built in per week that are focused on what's called heart rate variability, which is building cardiac output. There's a lot of research coming out. The better your aerobic base, the higher heart rate variability, the more likely you are to live a long life. So we want to tap into that. And I find the more people do that, the better their energy. It helps with recovery. It makes you more resilient to stress. And then I build in 2 days of just walking. Walking is one of the greatest tools we have to bring stress levels down and improve insulin sensitivity. So we have our hard days, our moderate days, and our easy days built over a week's period. And then I give everybody Sunday off for a play day to get out and have some fun. But it's set up in a safe manner to create success. Right now, I don't care how you look. Nobody should care how they look right now. That does not matter most. They should care about strong immune system, great energy, and stress reduction to survive this period of time. So I put that to the back burner. Right?
Yeah, it's like Maslow's hierarchy, right? We care about how we look in a bathing suit when we have the luxury of caring about that. Right now we're in war zone. Where it's a war zone.
Our beaches just got shut down. Like I guess you can go in your backyard, but it's just this reality. I've been preaching this for a long time. I don't care how you look. I care how you feel and how you perform in life, because that's what matters most. And you do things right over time, you'll get there and you'll look great and it stays. But we've been stuck in this war zone of stress the body, crush the body, force the change. And then we get there, and let's be honest, very rarely is anybody ever happy there. Like, oh my gosh, I feel horrible. I'm miserable. My cravings are insane. I'm hungry all the time. Nobody wants to be around me. No one loves me anymore because I look any better. Like this, I'm over this. So right. It's like, let's get past that lie of that being a better life and start using these tools to take care of ourselves and live a better life, to be more resilient and to be able to perform at a higher level and to engage the people that we love. That's the power of the right exercise program can provide for people. If they just get past the obsession of, I have to do this to look a certain way.
Right. I love that. So it's more about being functional. Yes. And so I'm assuming that there are, I think you touched on this, but I want to make sure people hear it clearly.
Yeah.
There are different levels for different people starting out. Because one of the most intimidating things, which now you don't have to worry about, that's one of the benefits. You don't have to worry about being intimidated by walking into a gym, right?
Yes.
It's just you, you in your underwear or you in your shorts or whatever it is you want to do. You be you. So you do you, or whatever it is my daughter says. Just be comfortable. But I'm assuming that there are different levels. There are different things people are going to be doing for different levels of fitness, right?
Yeah. So one of the greatest strategies I learned for something like this was from Dr. Jade Tita. And he says, go until you can't, rest until you can. Mm. This is how you make it individualized. So you'll see when the workout, there's a rep range of do like 10 to 20 reps. I want to be very specific. There are tempo protocols because when you move slower, the movement is safer and it makes your muscles work harder. So we get double benefit, but also reduction in risk. So there's slow tempos, a wide rep range, and then a rest period range. So you have stuff to play with. If you're more fit, do more reps, take less rest period. If you're less fit and you're new to this, do less reps, take longer rest periods. And over time, you can start getting more reps in, less rest period, so you can progress over 3 weeks, because these workouts are going to change every 3 weeks for as long as this goes on, right? As soon as the body begins to adapt to this mechanism that I have set in place, we change it up. I want to be very clear. I don't think exercises are what's important, right? So often we're doing too many crazy exercises. The body never has a chance to adapt to the exercise. So somebody will look at this and think, oh, this looks very basic because it's only four exercises. It's eight total exercises, four on each day. Yeah, they're basic, safe exercises that work a lot of muscles that you can adapt to over time for the change we're looking for. And they're going to be pretty safe for majority of people that are doing them. I'm not going to do these crazy circus act exercises that are super dangerous, because last thing I want to do right now is get hurt.
Right.
I've been having
you don't want to have to go spend time in a doctor's office.
No, exactly. And I've been having this conversation with my kids. Like, hey, probably not the best time to work on your new tricks on skateboards right now.
Right.
Let's just stick with what we're good at. We'll save that crazy stuff for later. So I put that all into play when I built this thing. It's not super sophisticated. It's not super fancy. It's not crazy exercise. You've seen all the exercises. I'll tell you that right now.
Right.
But the gold comes from the progression over time on these workouts.
You still, just like you can with our clinics, you can still access, if you do have an injury, if you have a problem, like I have scoliosis, I've had injuries. Now, that's why I actually worked out with Brad. That's why I actually went and saw a chiropractor and a sports medicine doctor before I started doing crazy stuff. And of course, first thing they told me was stop doing karate, and I'm not going to stop doing karate. But I was able to at least go learn how to like manipulate my body in a safe way.
Yeah.
and take care of myself. So you still can talk to chiropractors. You can talk to sports medicine doctors. You can talk to trainers like Kraft. They will talk to you through video, through Skype, through, you know, FaceTime. There's all sorts of ways. At our clinics, we're doing the same thing for people who are sort of having anxiety attacks right now and depression. Yeah. Really critical to take care of your mental health and your physical health right now. So if you do have an injury, make sure you're getting some advice on how the safest ways to exercise. How do you take care of, how do you modify something for your knee? My chiropractor was amazing at helping me with that for my scoliosis, right? How do you modify it? Which ones should I just completely avoid? And that's one of the reasons I work out with Brad. Well, normally right now I've had to modify my workout a lot because I'm not working out with a trainer. But when I was working out with you, one of the reasons I worked out with trainers all the time was because I can't lift heavy stuff over my head. I can't do that anymore, but I can have someone set it in my hands, right? I can't lift it up and over my head, but I can have, so you modify those things. That's why I worked out with trainers.
Yeah.
So now, you know, now we can't work out with trainers at all.
Yeah.
But you can talk to someone, find out how to modify an exercise for you. And like Brad is saying, I love what you said. What did Jade teach you? Do it till you can't, rest until you can.
Yeah, go until you can't, rest until you can.
Right. I like that.
Yeah.
And focus on, I always say, focus on what you can do and not on what you can't do.
Yeah.
If there are things you just can't do, that's okay. Go to the next thing that you can. There's plenty you can do.
So and I want people to think like, exercise for the rest of your life. Like, this isn't a 12-week transformation program. Those they have their place and their purpose, but there's usually a big rebound that comes with those. So this is more of an exercise for the rest of your life. We're not trying to change you in the next 8 weeks or 90 days.
No.
We're trying to start building on every workout. Get a little better. Get a little stronger. The next 3 weeks, change it up. Right? We are looking at exercising for the rest of your life. That's how I think people should work out and focus on things versus trying to crush themselves for a big change. And I do want to point out, like, if there are pain things you're dealing with, every exercise has a video and I have some modifications in there. But if something just hurts, even with the modifications, just don't do it.
Right.
Like, just skip one of them. You'll still get the workout effect we're looking for. Even if you have to skip one, you're going to do more of the other ones, but you're still going to get the benefits we're looking for.
Whenever I hear people complain and say, but I can't do this, I can't do that because I've got this problem, because I've got that problem, I always think of the example. One of my favorite examples is Natalie, who works. I hired her because I just couldn't resist her. Right.
Yes.
Natalie's in a wheelchair. She had a skiing accident when she was 16 and she broke her neck, and they told her she'd never walk again. And she was just like, you don't know me. You don't get to tell me whether or not I'm going to walk again. Now, she can't walk without assistance, but she actually gets up because she works so hard. She got up until that girl, like, worked so hard until she could get up and actually walk across the room with a walker.
Yeah.
And so she works out. Now, she's in a wheelchair. She doesn't have the use of her hands or her legs, but that girl works out so hard. And so if you think you can't work out, like, these are people I like to use as an example, you know, or, you know, my friend Jacob, who has, you know, pretty significant CP and so cerebral palsy, and he practices karate. He can't do everything, but he does it. What he does is so much. It's such a hard workout for him, and I'm so proud of him, and it's so impressive because he's not focusing on what he can't do. He focuses on what he can do.
Yes,
and he works his tail off, and that's what matters.
You know how many professional football players I've worked on that were told they'd never play again because of an injury, and they're back in the league playing better than ever?
Right.
Like, you can work around these things.
There she is. Natalie's on there.
I love it. It's not about perfection. It's about progression.
Right.
And I mean, I'm 45 or 44 now, and I'm nowhere near as big and muscular strong as I was at 35. It doesn't mean that I'm giving up and quitting.
Yeah, I don't want to hear it. I'm like, you're a baby compared.
Yeah, but I mean, it's just the reality. It's like, okay, well, I still want to be the best version of myself now with what I can, do.
Exactly.
So, yeah.
So I love all of these. Love you too, Natalie. I love all these people on here.
Julie Wilson.
So great. I've got so many people looking for answers. Yeah, it's amazing.
Yeah.
And I just, I'm thank you so much too for being willing to do this. Because I know, you know, you're coming from a world of professional athletes and beasts. I worked out at your gym when you used to be a part, part owner in a gym that I was pretty intimidated. I don't intimidate easily. But I was pretty intimidated walking into that gym.
Yeah.
There were beasts that worked out in there. But but now we're in a different time. And, you know, and you're willing to, like, help people just do it with nothing at home. And that's, you know, we're all just helping each other, right?
Yeah.
So this isn't a professional athlete's workout, although right now it probably is. Everyone's at home.
I've had to do the same thing for my professional athletes, my college athletes, my high school athletes. Like, we're kind of all stuck at home. The workout I put up on is the same workout I'm doing for myself. Like, right. I want to be super honest. Like, this is what I'm doing for myself. That's why I put it together. I'm like, just made it in a way where anyone could do it. Because it's funny. Here I am. I'm the strength coach. I have no weight equipment, no workout equipment at my house.
Right. So I did a live chat and I did it in my home gym. So I've got this amazing home gym that I set up, and the first thing I said was, I'm doing this intentionally here because I've been collecting equipment because it's so funny. I'm not into purses. I'm not into, I could care less about purses. I could care less about all these things. The things I care about are gym equipment and end of the world planning. Like, those are two things I've always cared about, right? So over the past 20 years, that's what I've been doing, putting together a gym and putting together my end of the world supplies. So now I'm like, oh, thank God I did that. But anyways, I wanted to show people, it's like, look, this is my gym, but you don't need any of this stuff. Like, you actually don't have to have any of this stuff.
Yeah, I don't have anything. I have zero. I have nothing. So, like, honestly, what I've given everyone is what even I'm doing myself, because I want the same benefits of what it's giving, the enhanced immune system, the more energy. I mean, it's stressful right now. I don't be able to reduce my stress loads. I've actually, still been able to sleep. And, like, my world's shut down. Like, most people, I have no idea when my world starts back up again. So it's like I'm in the same boat. So this is everything I'm giving to you guys is exactly what I'm doing for myself, because I believe it's the best route to go at this point in time in life.
Now, there are people who have not put together any, like, they don't even have basic stuff, like a set of dumbbells or whatever. And that's because oftentimes people live in an apartment building where they've got a gym.
Yeah,
but those gyms are closed now.
That's me. I had a whole facility there where I live that I could use.
Right. And now some people can't afford to, order that stuff, and that's fine. You don't need to. What you're saying is you don't need to. Some people can, and you still can order some of that stuff.
For sure. Yeah.
So, yeah, just some of the basics, like a jump rope and a set of weights and, maybe a ball.
Yeah.
With that, you can do a ton, or some bands.
Yeah.
You can do a ton of stuff with those things. That's going to advance your workout a little bit.
Yeah. If you can add weight loads to the exercise, it's awesome. I'm going to continue to build this thing just with body weight. But if you do have access to dumbbells or weights, great. Add those in. It'll make the exercises tougher. But I'm just going to be straightforward from here on out until we can get back into gyms and stuff. Everything I'm going to put on this app is going to be body weight oriented movements, not requiring any type of added equipment.
Right.
That's just the world I'm living in right now.
Right, exactly. And I think most people are we're worried. People are losing their jobs.
Yeah.
People are focused on food. They're focused on, I need to save money. And the last thing you're thinking about is ordering gym equipment. I get it.
Exactly.
So it's I think that's not where our priorities are at. And I think like you said something really important. Our bodies are designed.
Yeah.
Right. Our bodies are designed there's a reason walking is good for us. Right. It should be obvious because we're made to walk, to run. Those are the types of things that obviously physiologically it's easy for us to do.
Yeah.
So we shouldn't need a whole lot of stuff. We just have to be creative.
Exactly.
Right. We've just gotten out of the habit of thinking that way.
Yeah.
So braddavidson.com and the workout is all there. You have an app they can download.
Yeah, it gives you instructions on how to download the app. And there's also a free three video mini course teaching the ideas behind everything.
Okay.
So it teaches you why the workout's, how it's doing what it's doing, the kind of behind the scenes stuff, what it's doing for you. There's a video on safety mechanism, how to create more safety. And the third one is just kind of extra things you can do around the workouts to boost your immune system and things like that.
Excellent.
Yeah, they're 3 or 4 minute videos. They're super short, but to the point. Really kind of explaining what the whole point of this program is that I've created for everyone to use during this time.
Awesome.
Yeah.
And it's just really important that you guys actually are moving your bodies right now.
Yes.
The last thing you want to do, we're already sitting around more than normal.
Yeah.
We're doing oddly well here. I mean, I had my first sort of, if I'm going to be honest, my first sort of freak out day yesterday. It was the first day that I just sort of felt out of control. But it's not like I freaked out, but I just felt anxious about not being able to control things coming in my house. And it was just, I was just getting frustrated. But that was the first time I felt it. Because honestly, through this whole thing, we've been surprised at how oddly well we've been doing. And I've been catching up on so many things that I haven't been able to get to. I think every room in my house is now ridiculously organized. And we're normally so busy, I can't get to that stuff, right? Been doing puzzles with the kids. And it's just kind of crazy all the stuff you can get done if you're stuck at home.
Yeah.
or you could sit on your butt and watch TV.
Yeah.
So, but one is going to help you feel empowered. One's going to help you feel healthy. The other one is going to make you feel sick. Yeah. And it's going to make you sick.
Yeah.
So we don't want you doing that.
Exactly. Exactly. Right. Yeah.
Well, Brad, I want to thank you for joining. You helping me, your routines have helped me so much in the past that I wanted to be able to bring you on. And during this really critical time, you know, be able to share this with my community. There are just so many people asking. I've had so many people asking, what can I do at home?
Yeah.
So, I mean, maybe we can do another one where you actually show people a few things, but I think going to
website, for sure,
downloading the app are probably the best thing to do.
Well, and like I said, the app has videos of all the exercises, exactly how to do them, how to modify them if they can be modified. So it's pretty, I mean, it's set up really well.
Awesome.
So very self-explanatory. And so, but yeah, I would love to, if people want that, we can definitely do some demos and I can kind of instruct a little bit more on the specific exercises. People like to see that. So.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Perfect. Well, great. So I'm going to, I'll make sure that we share this on all of our sites so people have access.
Awesome. Well, have a good rest of the day.
You too. Take care. All right, guys. Take care. Bye-bye.